Motorsports Night here at the Nation's Side of Excitement, Thunder Road. Nice to have you all aboard as we get set for stock car racing on a beautiful night on top of Quarry Hill. The official pace car of Thunder Road International Speedbowl, the 1991 Chevrolet Camaro, courtesy of Cody Chevrolet on the Barre Montpelier Road. Our ambulance service, courtesy of Barretown EMS. Our wrecker crews, Blake and Loso on Route 14 in East Montpelier, and by Woodbury Auto, Route 2 in Montpelier. The Cody Chevrolet Thunder Road infield crew, David Jennison, our infield safety director. The American-Canadian Tour fire protection team, and last week's feature winners and award winners. We'll present them to you very shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, nice to have you with us here tonight as Napa Auto Parts presents stock car racing here at Thunder Road. To get things underway, it's my pleasure to introduce to you our feature winners and award winners from 1 week ago. Our defending champions, as always, will have their battle flags flying on the left-hand flagpole. First of all, our Wagner Break of the Week award winner in the Pepsi Flying Tiger division. Certainly had himself some bad breaks in the last couple of outings. Car number 57, the J&A Enterprises Buick Skylark. How about a round of applause for Jimmy Martin, the Break of the Week award winner in the 57 machine. Well, no question about our Gabriel Shock of the Week from 2 weeks ago. This fella got it upside down coming out of turn two, and it didn't stop dumping until he was on his lid about the third time in turn three. He's back and ready to grow after his second flipper of the year in 1991. Car number 56, Rick Flory, our Gabriel Shock, and a shocking experience indeed it was. Our defending champions, first of all, in the Alamumber Street Stock Division, the Barniers Trucking. Car number zero, Mark Barnier. And last week's main event winner in the Times Argus, double point mid-season championship for the Flying Tigers. First time back after a devastating crash at the Stanair Super Speedway in this automobile, and he brought it home number one last week. Car number 00, the Suntan Sams. Car number 00, Stevie Miller from Bristol. Your double point mid-season championship winner in the Flying Tiger division, and he'll be out tonight looking to make it two for two. Ladies and gentlemen, how about it? As these drivers saddle up, let's get a round of applause for these gentlemen. Send them on their way. Wish them good luck tonight as they attempt to qualify for the Napa Auto Parts Trophy Dash. Back from the land of the outlaws 1 week ago, they've had a week off, and they're ready for love here tonight. The Alamumber Street Stocks ready to shake, rattle, and hopefully not roll, or they'll be back on vacation. Car number 93, Wendell Daly, will be your pole sitter in heat number one tonight. Outside, the number 01 machine is Dave Patton. Wild Willie Herring on the inside of row two. Outside, the number 78 and Don Lowell. Ricky Roberts, the 36, starts fifth. Outside, the 58 of Brendan Moody. The 72 is Tom Vermette. Ralph Rockwell in the 81. The 64, flying Brian Williams. And car number 47 from Essex's Mike Rivers. The 31, Ralph Carroll riding shotgun. Heat number one is set to go for the Alamumber Street Stocks on Napa night here at the road. Wendell Daly and Dave Patton side by side for the green flag, and we're underway. The 0-1, Patton going high on the racetrack. Keep an eye on the 78, watch it three wide. Right up the pipe he goes for second place. Don Lowell in the Chevy, Monte Carlo up on the outside at turn number four for the lead now. Wendell Daly in the 93, the 78, Don Lowell. Bill Herring in the number six up to the third spot. 0-1, Dave Patton and Ricky Roberts on the inside. Look out, Daly leading on Lowell out of turn four. Full contact racing at the front of the pack. Don Lowell now is your leader. the 64 out of the back of the pack now has some room. Ricky Roberts, 36, to the outside for third, right behind Brian Williams. Roberts and Williams looking to go now. The 93 goes high, Wild Bill Herring down low for second. Cars all over the racetrack in heat number one for the Crunch Bunch. Herring now takes over second in the number six. Williams right behind the 64 now is third. Mike Rivers showing some smoke off the back of car number 47 as they run five deep on the back chute. Rivers goes up the middle. Down to the line they come, two laps to go. Look out, Rivers is over the top. Mike Rivers has got fire on the 47 machine. Fire into the hood of the 47 and the red flag is coming out. Red flag on the speedway. Nobody knows it, nobody cares. Red flag. Look at Bill Herring go, he's going to win. I'll bet he's not. Fire under the hood of the 47. Mike Rivers climbs out. He's okay. Safety crews are on the scene, and they'll extinguish the 47. Mike Rivers. Looks like the oil leak came to life under the hood. Tigers, the streets and the legends. You're not going to want to miss this one. Field is down to six cars as they're set to go green in heat number one. Brian up the inside takes over the lead in the 64. Rapid Ralph Rockwell, the Thunder Chicken, down low, second low, look out. Ricky Roberts gets the tag, the 72 are out, white flag is out. White flag is out, Ricky Roberts trying to get it out of harm's way. And Flying Brian down the back stretch for the final time. Brian Williams, one corner away from the checkered flag. Checkers are out, Flying Brian your winner. Ralph Rockwell is second, Dave Patton, Wendell Daly, and Tommy Vermeer. Well, while everybody else was losing their heads, Flying Brian kept his. And how's this for some qualifying success? 9 weeks of racing here at Thunder Road, Flying Brian Williams has won his heat seven times out of nine, and he comes from the back every single night. How about it, ladies and gentlemen, the Williams Salvage Chevrolet, Flying Brian, your winner in the 64. Anniversary. Brian and Debbie Williams are going to celebrate on the 30th of July, and we also understand, is this true that Red and Stella are going to have an anniversary on the 29th? Oh, my God. Two for the Crunch Bunch rolling out. The 0-2, Teddy Clark and Rick Fleury. Keep an eye on the 56. He's been upside down twice this year. And we're just past the halfway mark. The 84 of Sean McFarland. Skip Patton in the number 10 machine. Steve Craddock in the 65. Spuds McKenzie outside of the 68. Then Rick Dennis in the 19. Jerry Humister. Roseair Sear in the Deathmobile. The 85, Cal Pullen. And Jason Leo, car number 8. Field is green. Heat number 2. Teddy Clark down on the inside, the 0-2 is your leader. Rick Fleury trying to find the low groove, can't do it. Here comes McFarland up the inside of the 84. Three wide in turn number 4, look out, they're sideways, but everybody keeps it off the wall. Sean McFarland, the 84, goes to second, right behind 19, Jerry Humiston, and the Spudster up the inside. Spuds McKenzie now for it. Clark, the 0-2, holds onto the lead on the outside. Here comes Jerry Humiston. Clark almost off the back chute gathers it up. Teddy Clark using all the racetrack and a little bit more. Now the 19, Humiston is up to second. Jerry Humiston, three-time main event winner in 1991, is on the move. 19, Humiston. 68, Spuds McKenzie getting leaned on in four. Humiston to the outside. Halfway done in heat number 2 for the Crunch Bunch. The 0-2 Clark, 19 Humiston, Spuds McKenzie, Sean McFarland, and Patton on the outside in the 10 moving up. Spuds McKenzie now down to the inside for second. Agricultural Racing in turn 1, no harm, no foul. Here comes the Spudster. Look out, he's going to go for it. Three cars under a blanket, two laps to go, it's anybody's the 0-2 using the bank shot on the final lap to win it. As he comes out of turn four, doinks it off the wall and brings it home number one. Humiston, the 19, is third, 68. Spuds McKenzie is second. And ladies and gentlemen, your winner, one way or another, the 0-2, Teddy Clark in heat number two. Finished up front. Not a bad way to do it. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? And a round of applause, if you would, for the 0-2. Ted Clark, your heat two winner. Heat number three, rolling out behind the Cody Chevrolet pace car. The 17, Bob Patton, will be your pole sitter. Outside the 54, Steve Lovely. Wes Abbey from Northfield, the number 53, shows in third. Outside the number 87 is Ron Lowell. Frenchie LaFountain of the Knights of Thunder, car number 77, goes next in line. Outside the 25, the flashback car of Steve Coffey. Mark Barnier, winner 2 weeks ago in the Barnier's Trucking Chevrolet, goes next in line. Outside the 11 of Terry Reel. Claude Cross in car number 38, Jimmy Young in car number 1, the 33, Kurt Carpenter, and Bruce DeSomblo on the rear in car number 2. Look out, the leader's in the fence before we even get a green. Take one, fellas. Not a good start. Gets down on the infield and almost wipes out the whole county before the green comes out. Allen Lumber Street Stocks back for the first time in 2 weeks, and you can definitely see that they've toned down their act a whole lot tonight. Let's try it again. Patton on the inside, Lovely on the outside, green is out. The 17 again sideways on the bottom of the track, gathers it up. 54, Steve Lovely puts the nose out on top of the lead. Patton sideways again, coming back at him. All the way around, they slide it in. 17, Patton hanging on for all he's worth on the inside. Look out! Roll, Lowell goes three deep. Lovely takes the lead in the 54. Lowell now is second after a daring move on the back chute. Lowell has the lead. Ron Lowell not going to wait around for anybody tonight as that Ford Thunderbird is flying at the front of the pack. 54, Steve Lovely second. Look out, Bob Patton, Bob Patton, Bob Patton. He's in the hole. Oh, my heart, that's the end of him. Right down pit road he goes. You can see it coming. Look out, Frenchie LaFountain's headed for the exit. Come on back, 77. Terry Reel's down in the infield. Yeah, these guys are doing much better tonight. Barnier, Claude Cross, Jimmy Young. The battle is for the number two position as the 87 is all alone in the front. 54 and 53. Steve Lovely, Les Abbey, nose to nose for the runner-up spot with two laps to go now. Two laps to go, and it's Steve Lovely, the inside line with the advantage. Claude Cross, 39, moving up for third now. White flag coming out. One lap remaining. Claude Cross moving up to third. Final time in turn three and four. Checkered flag is out. Ron Lowell, easy win in the 87. Steve Lovely out of turn four is going, oh boy, I don't know. Photo finish for second and third. We'll wait for the scoring check on the 54 and the 38. Spot goes to the 38 of Claude Cross at the line. Second is the 54 of Steve Lovely. And a dominating performance here in heat number three for the Crunch Bunch. The Snap-on Tools for the 87, Ron Lowell, your winner. All right, first update of the night. On the favorite driver poll for the street stocks tonight, Mark Barnier is the point leader. Perry Fleming is second. Then a three-way tie between Big Daddy Don LaHue, Doug Murphy, and Jimmy Young. Side the 14, the Gerber baby, Chet DeVerney Jr. Dizzy Dean Gallison in the number 7, the 30 of Brent Currier. The point leader, Monty Lemaire, in car number 48. The 95 machine, Paul Schnabel, and riding shotgun, Lloyd Moritz in the 03 machine. Here we go. Heat four goes green in air racing. Big Daddy on the outside is your leader. Francis Miller in the 04 on the outside. Purple Perry and the Gerber baby moving up. The 5 of Perry Fleming. Chet Devarney in the 14 as the outside line moves. Big Daddy has the lead on the back chute. Purple Perry in the 5 going to second, and here comes the baby on the outside. Chet Devarney in the 14 looking to move up now. 69, Don LaHue. Purple Perry in the 5 goes to the inside of the back straightaway. Perry Fleming now taking over the lead. Chet Devarney trying to fill the hole in the 14. Schwartz lanes on the front chute. Purple Perry, now your leader. Big Daddy in second. The Gerber baby and Brent Currier. Devarney now down low. Keep an eye on the 69 and the 14. Chet Devarney wants to go racing. Brent Currier up on the outside in the 30. Devarney down low in the 14. He's got the whole shot in the back chute. Look, Gowdy backs out of it as the 69 shuts him down. Full contact racing for the number 2 position now. Big Daddy, Don LaHue, now trying to hold off the Brent Currier machine. Currier on the outside of the 30. This time by, we've got 2 laps to go. 2 to go for Purple Perry. Look out, Currier almost gets the fence. Currier in the 30 almost gets a piece of the wall on the front straightaway. As Big Daddy holding off all comers in the 69. Down to the line. White flag is out. White flag is out. The battle is for second and third. Don LaHue, 69. Chet Devarney, 14 up the outside. Final time out of 4. Purple Perry wins it in the 5. Second is Big Daddy. Third, I believe, was Chet Devarney. We'll wait for the call. Second photo finish of the night in the street stock division. This time it's for third and fourth. Purple Perry gets the win in the 5. The 69, Don LaHue is second. Third spot by a nose goes to Chet Devarney. And the 30 of Brent Currier finishes fourth. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dean's Auto Parts Chevrolet from Bethel, Vermont. Purple Perry Fleming, your winner. Hands together for Purple Perry, the Dean's Auto Parts machine, your winner in Heat 4. She may not even make it to the racetrack. He gets the pinch in Heat number 4 as he put the pinch on Brent Currier into the front stretch wall. Eugene Robinson, please report to the front ticket gate. Eugene Robinson to the front gate, please. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here they come. Pepsi Flying Tigers ready to roll for their first event of the evening. On the point from Morrisville, the New Boys Construction Ford Thunderbird, Phil Scott in car number 14. Outside, the number 20. From Warren, Vermont, Tony Andrews in the Chevrolet. The 29 is Brett Wheeler from Waterbury. The 55, Tom Tiller. Richard Bootsy in the number 13. The 16 of Kip Stockwell in the Napa Auto Parts machine. Pat Corbett from Williamstown in car number 5, and on the tail, the 47 of Mark Graves. Here we go. Heat number 1 for the Tigers goes straight on the front straightaway. Tony Andrews on the outside, bubbles, dances, weaves his way to the front in car number 20. The 14, Phil Scott riding low in second on the outside. Here comes the Colonel. The Kentucky Colonel, Tom Tiller, on the outside line looking for second. Tiller on the outside has it. Tony Andrews, car number 20, is your leader. Sideways in four, gathers it up. As the veteran, Tom Tiller, begins to move in on him. 55, Tiller, look! The 14 and the 16 hook bumpers in turn 2. They're both around but underway. goes high, gives way to the lead draft, and Andrews brings him down. Halfway done in heat number one. Tony the Tiger has led all the way on the outside pole in car number 20. Tom Tiller the 55 second, then Brett Wheeler and Pat Corbett in the five. Tom Tiller wants the outside. Here comes the Colonel on the back chute. 55, Tiller ready to race the high line. Laps winding down. It's Tiller by a nose at the start finish line. Tom Tiller on the high side gets it done in the 55. Andrews now back to second. On the high line, Brett Wheeler trying to follow through. Two laps to go now. Second. Andrews dropping back to third, and here comes the five. Pat Corbett on the move. Corbett pulling up with the white flag out now. Pat Corbett rim rides the outside of Tony Andrews. Side by side, the battle for third. Checkered flag will fly, and in turn number four, Tom Tiller, your winner. Wheeler is second. Another close call for third. Once again, a narrow finish for the third spot, and they'll give it to the number five of Pat Corbett. Brett Wheeler, the 29, is second, and ladies and gentlemen, one of the great names of racing here at Thunder Road gets it done in heat number one. Here's Tom Tiller, your winner. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the happiest duty I've had in a long, long time here at Thunder Road. Those of you that were at the Santair Super Speedway about a month ago saw what was without question the most terrifying crash in the history of our Flying Tiger division. Bobby McCaskill since that day has been hospitalized until yesterday, and we're happy to tell you that he's right here tonight with us to watch the action. Bobby, welcome back.
Okay, good. Happy to be here.
Not quite ready to strap in yet, though, huh?
Not quite. Won't be long.
How long do they say? You're working hard, I know that.
I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see how things go.
Sit back and have a seat. I know you're going to be an interested spectator. We'll give you the best seat in the house tonight, right next to Barkham. You can help make decisions.
Okay, that sounds like fun.
All right. Bobby McCaskill, ladies and gentlemen, he's back. He's feeling good tonight. Happy to be back, and we're happy to have him. All right, let's get back to it. Heat two for the Tigers. Brian Kilburn in the... Bobby says, boy, it's a different view from up here. Brian Kilburn and Pete Fecto in the 75. The 97 Dave Gibbs, Red Mead, then Mike Knapp in the 80, the 25 of Dave Whitcomb as Pete Fecto is off the outside pole to lead it. Fecto, the Morrisville driver, out on top, and it's Boss Hogg, Red Mead in second. Red Mead coming off a tremendous drive last Saturday night at Airborne where he nearly won it all. Mead is in second. 25, Whitcomb is third, and on the outside, here comes Davey Gibbs. Dave Gibbs, the AMC Concord, has the fourth spot. And right behind, out of the back of the pack, it's Jim Silly. 68, Silly now fifth. Pete Fecto out on top. Red Mead holding second. Keep an eye on the 25 machine. Whitcomb beginning to close up. Dave Whitcomb, 25, out of the back of the field, pulling up on Red Mead. Mead in the Ford. Whitcomb in the Buick. Out of turn number four. We're halfway down at E2. Fecto all by himself at the front. Mead and Whitcomb second and third. Then Dave Gibbs, Jim Silly, and Mike Knapp in a bunch for fourth. Dave Gibbs holding the inside line. Silly up on the outside. The 80 Mike Knapp. Here comes Dave Whitcomb, 25 going for second now. Whitcomb trying to make the charge as the laps wind down here in heat number two. 75, Fecto, Mead in the one. 25, Whitcomb and Jim Silly coming up the outside. will come out this time. At the front, it is all Peter Fecto, the 75, a quarter mile away now. Brad Mead holding on to second. Whitcomb is third. Then Silly, Gibbs, and Michael Neff. Final time around as they work the back chute. Out of turn four, checkers are out. Give it to Pete Fecto in the 75. Brad Mead second, Dave Whitcomb, Jim Silly, and David Gibbs. Solid run at the front of the pack by Pete Fecto as the 75 gets the break off the outside of row one and goes wire to wire in heat number two. Ladies and gentlemen, the Riverview Garage Pontiac Pete Fecto from Morrisville, your winner. See if we can pull a ticket or two after this qualifier. We've got all kinds of prizes tonight. If we don't start giving them away quick, we probably won't have enough time. Heat three, the 22 Gary Caron from Williston is your pole sitter. Outside, the number 57 machine, Jimmy Barton in a J&A Buick. Mark Marsh from Orford, New Hampshire starts third in the 0-9. Fourth is car number four, the Pulis Insurance machine for Big Bigelow of St. Johnsbury. Brian Campbell in a Carter Sprinkler machine starts next in the fifth spot. Outside last week's mid-season champion, the 00 Steve Miller. And right behind Miller, the 1989 track champion, the 27 of Berger Blake. Here we go out of turn four. No go. No start that time around as the 22 Gary Caron with too much of a jump. Caution flag out. They'll form it up and try her again. As Caron in the 22 took the hot charge out of four, Jim Barton hanging back in the 57. They'll take one and try it again. Field sorting it out. They'll try again out of turn four this time. 22, Gary Caron, 57, Jim Barton, set for a go. Heat three, down to the line, this time they're away. Caron on the inside, has the break. 57, Jim Barton ducks it down low into second. Here comes Big Bigelow, the Pontiac moving up high. Bigelow trying to get the bike, can't do it as Mark Marsh ducks underneath of the 09 machine. Everybody having a little bit of trouble getting a bite here tonight as Gary Caron bobbles at top of the field. 22, Caron, your leader. 57, Barton is second. The 09, Mark Marsh, 83, Brian Campbell. Keep an eye on the 57, the veteran, Jimmy Barton, beginning to gain ground on the lead once again now. Berger Blake and Steve Miller trapped in the back of the field. They are not making progress. Blake up to the number five spot. Berger Blake is going to have to get on his horse. The 27 now to the outside. Loses ground in four. 00 Miller, the 27 Blake. The high point driver is getting nowhere on the top of the racetrack. Halfway down this time, and it continues to be Gary Caron. 22, 57, Jimmy Barton, the 09 Marsh, and here comes the Berger up the outside. Berger Blake with the challenge for Brian Campbell in the 83 machine. Mark Marsh, the 09, holding third. Blake rim riding on the outside, trying to hang on. Campbell looking low, can't find the room. Barton secure in second. The battle for third, fourth, and fifth. The 09 Marsh, 27 Blake, Campbell and Miller with two to go. Berger Blake on the outside. Campbell almost throws it away. Blake in the 27 now is third. Right behind is Stevie Miller. White flag is out. One more. The high point drivers finally get the break out of the back. Lake is third. Look out, Bigelow loops it in the four. Checkered flag is coming out. It's Gary Caron, your winner. Jim Martin is second. Berger Blake, Steve Miller, and Mark Marsh, the top five. Everybody having a tough time getting a handle on the racetrack tonight. As these drivers sliding all over the asphalt, looking to get themselves qualified. Third spot at the drop of the checkered flag from the back of the pack, the 27 of Berger Blake. In second, Jimmy Barton in the J&A 57. And ladies and gentlemen, your winner in heat number three, the Caronzotto Pontiac, Gary Caron in car number 22. Live on ACRN, the American Canadian Racing Network. Friday night's event from Scotia Speed World, Halifax, Nova Scotia. They're looking for an airtime a little bit after the 9 o'clock hour on Friday night. And then on Sunday afternoon, the Bud Triple Crown 150 at the Riverside Speedway in Antigonish, Nova Scotia. You can tune that one in on your local ACRN station at approximately 2:30 on Sunday afternoon. George Como will be trackside, AM 550 WDEV here in the Waterbury, Montpelier area. In Burlington, you can tune it in on WVMT, AM 620 in Colchester. Heat 4 set to roll. The 31 Lance Furrow, the 69 Rupert Irwin, nose to nose in row number one. Mike Pelkey in the 85, the 49 is Mark Lanphier. Mike Potter and Joey LeCaire in row three, the 40, Dwayne Lanphier riding shotgun. Heat four goes green. On the outside, the flipper takes somebody to the lead. Rupert Irwin on the back chute has it. 69 Irwin taking over. Lance Furrow, the 31, back to second. Mike Pelkey, 85, 49, Mark Lanphier. Rupert Irwin, the flipper. Five car lengths in hand over Lance Furrow. Mike Pelkey, the 85, then side by side for fourth. The 23, Mike Potter. 49, Mark Lanphier. Now it's a brother combo. Dwayne Lanphier to the inside in the 40 machine. Tough sledding on the outside line as Mark Lanphier goes backwards. Rupert Irwin all alone and pulling away. The 69 moving out. 31, Furrow is second. Pelkey, Potter, and Dwayne Lanphier. Single file all the way back to the final two cars. The 15, Joey LeCaire, 49, Mark Lanphier battling. The flipper is pulling away. 69, Rupert Irwin all by himself now. Lance Furrow holds that second spot. Then Mike Pelkey, Mike Potter, and Dwayne Lanphier. Lanphier's thrown everything but the dirty laundry at that outside groove, but he can't find the handles up high tonight. Laps beginning to wind down in heat number four. As Rupert Irwin with a solid run at the front of the pack. Irwin has been unchallenged all the way in this one. Lance Furrow second. Then Pelkey, Potter, and Dwayne Lanphier. Lanphier again looking high out of turn number two. Dwayne Lanphier wants to get it done, but he can't get the bite in the 40 machine. Field coming down to the line. White flag is out. We got one remaining. One lap to go for the flipper in the 69 machine. Rupert Irwin out of four, looking for the checkered flag. Checkers are out. The flipper, your winner. Lance Furrow, Mike Pelkey, Mike Potter, and Dwayne Lanphier. Tough sledding in the outside groove tonight in heat number four. But Rupert's Ron Lowell. Purple Perry in the five, the Spudster in the 68. Then the Gerber Baby and Jerry Humister. Rapid Ralph and Claude Cross. Brent Currier and the 64 flying Brian Williams. Semi-time for the Crunch Bunch underway. Teddy Clark, the 02, the 01, Dave Patton side by side. Nobody getting the break. They're too wide all the way back through the field. Out of turn four, the 01, Patton by a nose in your leader. Dave Patton pulls her down in the number one position. on the outside. Here comes the 87, Ron Lowell. The Ford Thunderbird working up high one more time. Lowell goes to second. 3-1 out of the front chute. Everybody gets through it. Dave Patton in the 01. 87, Ronnie Lowell. Ted Cork sideways. Here comes the Spudster. Spuds McKenzie way to the top in the 68 machine. McKenzie making the Brew Crew on the top of turn two. McKenzie now is third. Clark in the 02, fourth, then Jerry Humiston. Challenge for the lead on the front chute. It's Ron Lowell going to work. Battles all over the racetrack. The 01, Dave Patton, 87, Ronnie Lowell, side by side. Look out, Purple Perry got him. Everybody's all oh, look out, they're heading. My heart. Jerry Humiston does the slow-mo roller. Well, if you got a flip, folks, that's the way to do it. He had time to order pizza on the way over. That was wonderful. I don't know if we can even call that a flip. There's Jerry. He's out. He's all right. Now he's going to go home and tell everybody he barrel rolled it right down the straightaway. Oh, it was incredible. You never seen anything like that. The problem is, this car right now is perfectly undamaged. There is nothing wrong with this machine. But wait till they flip it back over. Then you'll see some damage. They're going to rip this thing all apart. He could, if they had a gentle lay, if they had three or four mattresses to lay down there, he'd come out of the back and win this thing yet. But look, they're going to flip it right onto the ambulance, and then we'll have some... Look, the ambulance is out, making sure everyone's all right. Can you imagine the ambulance crew thinking anyone could possibly have been hurt in that thing? Here it comes. Oh, I don't know. He didn't hurt it. I don't think he even cracked the windshield. Now, this is the semi. These guys are already qualifying, even though. Am I right? Yeah, I wrote it down. That's all. It's the only way. Here they come. Turn four, looking for a go. Breathe it out. The semi is rolling. 01, Dave Patton. 87, Ron Lowell. Mr. Mustache on the outside moving up now. Lowell in the Ford, the Spudster. 68, Spuds McKenzie, he's not down yet. Hang on, Spudster. Dave Patton in the 01, running the wheels off it on the inside. 87, Ron Lowell. Then the Spudster and Poipole Perry in the 5 machine. 87, Lowell that time across the near their leader. Ron Lowell taking over. Lowell in the Ford. 01, Dave Patton, the Spudster goes high, and here comes Purple Perry. Perry plumbing the third down. The Spudster's going to drive it off the racetrack. Mark my words, the Spudster's going to drive it to the parking lot. The 68 Broad sliding it through turn four. Look out, Jack McKenzie. Out and Ron Lowell can walk it home from here. Ron Lowell can get out and push now. The 87 is home free. Quad Cross in second. The 68, Spuds McKenzie, then the Gerber baby and Rapid Ralph. Here they come. Lowell your winner. Cross is second. The Spudster, Rapid Ralph and the baby. Well, apparently the hand slapping is not confined to the street stocks tonight. We've had a DSQ in the tech line in the Tiger division. Matter of fact, he carried the checkered flag just a moment ago. The number 22 machine, Gary Caron, has been disqualified. He's out of there, and the 75, Pete Fecto, inherits the point. Fecto, your pole sitter. 69, Rupert Irwin will go on the outside. Brad Wheeler in the 29, the 85, Mike Pelkey. Tom Tiller and Red Mead in 3, Dave Whitcomb and Steve Miller, Pat Corbett, Berger Blake, the 31 Lance Furno, Jim Barton, and Gary Karen. Gary Karen failed the tech line. They're going to send him back to the garage. Nice try, though. I'd have done it in his position. 75, Peter Fecto. 69, Rupert Irwin. Take one, take one. They're a mile ahead of everybody else. Loving it. Tom Tiller and Red Mead in two. Dave Whitcomb and Steve Miller now inherit row number three. Row four, the five of Pat Corbett, then Berger Blake. The 31, Lance Furno. 57, Jimmy Martin. And then the 75 and the 69 out back. Well, it could be worse. We don't have a penalty box for the Tigers yet. Take one remains on the field. And an 85 on the front. Tom Tiller and Red Mead, the two veterans in row two, then Dave Whitcomb and Steve Miller, Pat Corbin and Berger Blake, Lance Furno, Jimmy Bart, Pete Becto, and the flipper. Here we go. Semi-feature on the line as the green flag flies. Rupert Irwin's taking it high. The 69's had trouble right off the bat. The flipper may not be able to get it in gear. They're fighting it out at the front. Everybody's all over the place, and we've got yellow. The track's a mess, I do believe. And Mike Pelkey outside. Whoa, right over the top goes Pelkey. The 85 straight on and over. 85, Pelkey kept it on all four, but he's over the top of the banking. Out once again. Tiger semi having a devil of a time. As Mike Pelkey got the break on the outside of row one and went straight on over the top. That is going to be one you don't want to miss. 1 week from tonight, the Chitwoods are back here at the road. We're set. Wheeler and Tiller now in row number one. Green is out. 55, Tom Tiller with a nose up. 29, Wheeler. 55, Tiller, then Red Mead and Dave Whitcomb. Top six cars, nose to tail out of four. Tom Tiller has it now. The Kentucky Colonel hooks it off the outside pole and leads. 55, Tiller. The 29, Wheeler now second. Here comes Davey Whitcomb in the 25. Whitcomb going to the outside. The 29 Wheeler losing ground. Whitcomb is second. Berger Blake is third. Wheeler's in trouble in the 29 machine. Brent Wheeler falling off the pace on the front straightaway. Tom Tiller in the 55 building up the lead now. The 25 Dave Whitcomb is second. Third is Berger Blake in the 27. Red Mead in the one, the double zero. Steve Miller nose to nose for four. Miller on the outside looking to take it over. He's got it in four. The Kentucky Colonel looking to go two for two. He won his qualifier. He leads the semi now. Tiller out in front. The 25 of Whitcomb gaining ground in the number two spot. 27, Berger Blake. The double zero, Steve Miller. Halfway down this time. Dave Whitcomb is closing ground on the lead. The 25 moving in turns three and four. Dave Whitcomb pulling up now. Steve Miller pulling up on the back bumper of the 27. Berger Blake now trying to hold on to the third spot. 55 Tiller, the 25 Whitcomb. Blake and Miller running single file in turn three. Laps winding down for the Kentucky Colonel. Miller, the double zero, looking high in three, bubbles momentarily. Blake drives away, holds on to third place. Nobody able to get a bite on the outside tonight. 25, Whitcomb is there on the back straightaway. The lead has vanished now for Tom Tiller. Two laps to go, and Whitcomb looking high. Two laps remaining in the semi-feature. Tom Tiller, 55 year leader. 25 Whitcomb, 27 Blake, Steve Miller, the double zero. White flag is out now. Tom Tiller, one lap away from the shot at the triple crown. Here comes Berger Blake. 27 Blake looking to steal it. Checkered flag coming out. The semi to Tom Tiller. Blake is second. Whitcomb third. Well, we've been waiting all summer long for the Kentucky Colonel to get some good luck on his side, as the Tiller's automotive machine has been fast every single week, and now the Colonel's got a big one coming. He's won his heat. He wins the semi. $400 in the Couillard Heating Oil Triple Crown tonight. Tom Tiller, the 55, will run for it. Would love to take home the Couillard's money tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, how about it? He's two for two this evening. The Ehlers RV 55, Tom Tiller from Access Clear winner. This is the final chance to qualify for tonight's Napa Auto Parts Trophy Dash. Top three drivers get the option to move on and start at the tail end of the field. The rest will hook and haul it to the Airborne Raceway on Saturday night. Richard Bootsy in the 13, the 80 Mike Knapp, side-by-side in one. Then Big Bigelow and Mark Lanphier in two. Phil Scott and Guy Brown in the Ford products. Then Joey LeCaire and Kip Stockwell, Brian Coburn and Gary Caron. Top three drivers advance to the main. Green is out of the B is racing. Mikey Knapp with a big jump on the outside in car number 80. Knapp is your leader. 13, Richard Bootsy, side by side for third. The four of Big Bigelow, 49, Mark Lanphier up high. Top three cars advance to the main. Big Bigelow takes over the spot. Bigelow in car number four, now the man on the hot seat. Look out, LeCaire and Phil Scott get into it. Scott goes around. The 14 is back underway and we stay green. Mike Knapp out in front of the 80. Richard Bootsy second. Here comes Mark Lanphier to the inside. Lanphier in the 49 needs one to qualify. Bigelow going high. Lanphier down low. They're nose to nose for the final spot now. The battle for the third and final transfer. 49, Lanphier. Bigelow in the four. Leaning on each other in one and two. Nobody giving ground on the back chute as Lanphier pulls ahead now. The 49 machine takes over third place. Mark Lanphier, the 49, now is the man on the bubble. The 57, Jim Barton running second. Mike Knapp at the front. Car number 80, your leader. Big Bigelow sideways, loops it on the back chute. Look out, here comes the field. Whoa! Holy cow! Gary Caron takes the nose off Big Bigelow's car and the left front corner off the 22 machine. Man, oh man, that was close. Big Bigelow, I don't think that car is damaged a bit, but he took the header panel clean off car number four. Wow, that was close. Bigelow will limp it back on pit road, and that is one lucky customer. 2 feet further back, and that's a former race car. Budweiser National 500, but next Thursday night we'll be back. There's no wonder everybody's asking. If you show up at the back gate, or the front gate rather, on Sunday for the 500, so next Thursday night, bring your $20 bill and get a three-day advance sale ticket to the Bud National 500. We're set to go. Four-car break at the front of the pack. The 80 Mike Knapp, 49 Mark Lanphier up the inside. Lanphier, 49, looking for second. And here's Kip Stockwell in the hunt. Kip Stockwell. And the Randolph Auto Parts Napa machine out of the back, going for third now. Stockwell by a nose has the spot. We are halfway down in the B feature, and it's Kip Stockwell now, the third qualifier. Kip Stockwell, the Napa car number 16, has the spot on the back chute. Stockwell, now the final qualifier in the 16 machine. Mike Knapp out on top in the 80, 49 Lanphier second. Bootsy sideways on the back chute, losing ground. Kip Stockwell looking high on Lanphier in the 16 machine. Stockwell is the man on the hot seat. Three to qualify. He is third now. Lanphier, the 49, is second. Mike Knapp in the 80 has led all the way at the front. A lap's winding down in the last chance qualifier. Mike Knapp, Mark Lanphier, Kip Stockwell with the qualified spots. This time we'll have two to go. Two to go this time for Michael Knapp. Lanphier and Stockwell on the outside. White flag will fly this time. Here comes the boot. Richard Bootsy coming back into it. White flag is out. One lap to go in the B feature. One lap to go. Stockwell trying to hold out of the spot. Final time in a 3 and 4. Checkers are coming out. Here they come. It's going to be Mike Knapp, your winner. Lanphier second. Stockwell third. Richard Bootsy one spot out of the money in the 13. Raining. Forget it. Mike Knapp of the Pete's Auto Machine gets it done in the B feature tonight. Big jump off the outside pole. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Mike Knapp, your winner. Michael, good job. Tough racetrack tonight.
2 weeks in a row. I don't like coming out of the B, but I like to win it.
Coming out of the B is better than not coming out of the B, though.
Definitely.
I guarantee you're moving on.
Definitely.
Good luck. Mike Knapp, car number 80, will start shotgun in the main event tonight for Napa Auto Parts. Rolling out. This is it for the Crunch Bunch. Showtime. Napa Auto Parts, trophy dash for the Evan Lumber Streets, rolling onto the Speedway. Pole position will go to the number 93 machine of Wendell Daly. Outside, the 02 Ted Clark will start second. Row 2, the 04 Francis Miller. And car number 01 Dave Patton. The 54 Steve Lovely starts on the inside of row 3. And on the outside, looking for the triple crown tonight, the 87 of Ron Lowell. Rick Gillen. Gilliland in car number 70. The 5 of Purple Perry Fleming in row 4. Row 5, the 36 of Ricky Roberts and the Spudster. Spuds McKenzie in the 68 machine. Steve Copping in the flashback photo, 25. Outside, the 14 from Georgia, the Gerber baby, Chet DeVarney Jr. The 72, Tom Vermette. Rapid Ralph Rockwell from Wilkin in the 81 machine. The Deathmobile, Roseanne Sear in car number 70. Then the 38 from Wilkin, Claude Cross. Brent Currier from Johnson in car number 30. The 64, Flying Brian Williams. Cal Pullen in the number 85 machine. The number 2 driver in the street stock standings, Jimmy Young in car number 1. Point leader on the Edel Number Street Stock Tour, Monty Lemaire, the Enduro Warrior in car number 48. And outside, Lemaire, the number 0, Mark Barnier in the Barnier's trucking machine. Dizzy Dean Gallison in the number 7. The 47 from Essex's Mike Rivers. Car number 8, Jason Leo. And riding shotgun, he's back. Jerry Humiston, after being upside down in the 19, is ready to roll. Problem. Oh man, they are shuffling it up in the middle of the field. The 0-2 Clark is in the wall, bounces off, no trouble. 93, Wendell Daly. Francis Miller in second. Steve Lovely and Ron Lowell on the outside. 87, moving up now. Lowell on the charge. Move on the inside for the lead. Francis Miller in the 0-4 now. Miller finds the hole on the inside. Daly hung up on the top side. Steve Lovely and Ron Lowell right behind looking for room. Francis Miller in the 0-4, your new leader. Daly back to second spot. Third on the outside, the 87, Ron Lowell. Lowell now is up to the third spot. Ronnie Lowell looking for the triple crown is two spots away. Lowell is third. Wendell Daly second. Francis Miller the leader. Challenge on the inside. Lowell now has second. Ron Lowell now the number 2 automobile. Look out, over the top goes Purple Perry. Steve Copping the 25 is blown the right front tire. Perry coming back in the number 5. Field Racing 3, yellow flag is out. Yellow on the field. Whoa, boys! Lights are down on the Cody Chevrolet pace car. We're set to go racing. Here comes Steve Copping. Francis Miller. Francis Miller and Ron Lowell. Green is out and they're racing for the lead. Whoa, they're tangling four. Look out, Nelly. Oh! Everybody. Oh, Rockwell almost got over. Look out, Irene. Yellow flag. Yellow flag for a multi-car jingle in turn 4. Well, this came at a rather opportune time because I was just going to announce last call on the 50-50. Kate is right behind the tower, and if you haven't got one yet, you're almost out of luck. Last call on 50-50. She's got about 3 more minutes to sell, and then we're going to call them in and tally up the total. The 36, Ricky Roberts, and Steve Lovely in the 54. Out of their cars? Okay, they'll have a little chat. Hey, Steve, how's it going? Great, Rick, you. Last call for 50-50 behind the announcer's tower. Get them now, or don't get them at all. Francis Miller in the 04 is your leader. The 87 are on low, continues to lurk. Ladies and gentlemen, the grandstand area, we ask your cooperation and please keeping the aisles clear at all times. Regulations require us to keep the aisles clear for easy travel. We appreciate your cooperation there. Pace cars in, we're ready to go with six down and an Napa dash for the street stocks. Here they come. Miller on the inside. Lowell on the outside. Green is out. Ron Lowell on the outside has it. Lowell now the leader for the third time tonight. Miller is back to second. The 30. Oh, look out. Flying Brian gets whacked. He's all right. Thank God Stella wasn't here to see that one. Brent Currier in the 30, up on the outside for second place. Currier in the Buick riding high. Francis Miller, the Chevrolet on the inside. Currier by half a car length has it. Brent Currier takes over second. Francis Miller back to third. Wendell Daly in the 85 Cal Pullen. Right behind is Monty LeMaire. Monty LeMaire, the point leader out of the back of the pack. On the outside is going for fifth place. Great ride by Laurier as he goes high in turn four. The 85 and the 48 have come from way out back to run fourth and fifth. The Laurier gaining ground on the back chute. Look out, Jason Leo gets nailed. Mike Rivers over the top. Quad crossing ball. Field try to refly. Look out, they're whacking again. Yellow flag is out. Yellow on the speedway. 38, quad cross. Jason Leo, the 47 of Mike Rivers, Dean Gallison, and Steve Coppick. Here comes the 47 back. Or if you have any or all of those numbers, the back door of the tower is where you want to be for an Apple Legend hack. Here we go. Restart on the line, and they're under green and leaning hard. Ron Lowe holds off the charge. Lowe holds the lead. Brent Currier holds on to second. Cal Pullen now third, and here comes the Laurier on the outside. Monty LeMaire all the way to the wall. Monty LeMaire from the back of the pack going for fourth place now. The 48 moving up. He's got fourth. Ron Lowe being challenged for the lead on the inside lane. 87 Lowe. Currier in the 30. Cal Pullen, Monty LeMaire, Spuds McKenzie, and the Gerber baby. Halfway down this time. Halfway done. Good battle for the number six position. Chet DeVarney on the outside. Here comes the 48. Monty LeMaire way to the top of the track trying to move. LeMaire off the racetrack, gathers it up and loses one. 87 Lowell, the 30 of Currier. Cal Pullman, and now the Spudster is fourth. 68, Spuds McKenzie in fourth. Monty LeMaire back to fifth, and the Gerber baby and Jimmy Young. LeMaire back to the inside of McKenzie. Can't find room to work on a back chute. Chet DeVarney moving into the 14. Look out! As Wendell Daly gets it front and rear. Oh, I thought the Gerber baby was going to burp Wendell Daly for sure. Chet DeVarney, he may need a new set of Pampers after that one. I thought he had the wall for sure. Pace car coming in. Here we go. A 10-lap dash for the cash. Ron Lowe and Brent Currier, Cal Pullen and the Spudster, go! Miller's bunched there. He's dragging a bumper. Whoop, Francis Miller gets him anyway. 85, Poulin is your leader. 48, Monty LeMaire, look out for the tire. Jerry Humiston's got runner on five tires. Jerry Humiston's got Jimmy Young's tire. Oh, there it goes through the infield. It's all right. Five laps to go for Cal Poulin. The 85 is your leader. 48, Monty LeMaire is second. Brent Currier third. Jerry Humiston, Flying Brian, and Mark Barre are the top six. Oh, look out! Poulin is sideways! 85, 48, and 30. Off the front of the pack. Laps winding down. Cal Poulin trying to bring it home. The Warrior is there in the 48. Monty LeMaire looking to the outside. Poulin is sideways. Here comes the Warrior. Monty LeMaire on the back straightaway trying to steal it. Two laps to go. Two to go. The Warrior has the lead at the line. Monty LeMaire out of two has the lead. Look out. LeMaire has it as the white flag is coming out. 48, LeMaire. 85, Poulin with one to go now. Oh, the Warrior's off. Poulin hits him. Brent Currier takes it. Cal Poulin is out in front. White and yellow. White and yellow on the field. Checkers are coming out. Cal Poulin is low. The 30, Brent Currier has won it. 85, Poulin is second, and I believe Mark Barre has taken third. We'll wait for the word from scoring. Tonight. Well, we got happy crews all over the house in this one. Terry Ryan from Napa down here to present the hardware. And our number three finisher tonight, somehow as they piled it up on the last lap, Mark Barre in the zero machine. Mark, congratulations. Come on up here. Say hello to Terry Ryan. He's got your third place trophy and a new Napa hat for you. That was a little bit wild at the end.
Yeah, we were just in the right place at the right time.
Looked like everybody kind of got goofed up. There was a lot of oil laid down up there, looked like.
Yeah, it was pretty slippery out there. I'd just like to thank my sponsors. And this one's from Mountain Jack and Castaway today.
Okay, congratulations, Mark. Mark Barre, car number zero, ladies and gentlemen, your winner. Well, I'll tell you what, I don't know if I want to say congratulations or condolences, but he's smiling right now. A good second for Cal Poulin in the 85. Attaboy, Cal. Terry Ryan with your trophy. What happened up there?
I got pretty excited. I come up through the front pretty close there. Got right up in the front quick, and my right side tires started fading. I was sliding through every corner, just holding on all I could, and we come into some lap traffic, and I think that's what held everybody off wrong with it for me.
Happy for second?
We'll take it any day.
Attaboy. Cal Poulin, 85 from Randolph, ladies and gentlemen, second.
And also, I'd like to thank my sponsor, M&M Beverage, and Randolph Napa, for all the help they give me and my crew.
Attaboy. Good job. Cal Poulin, the 85. And I'll tell you what, he's in the right place at the right time tonight. This car was up front all night long. The 30 Brent Currier, your winner, ladies and gentlemen. First place trophy from Terry Ryan in Napa. I'll ask you the same question. What happened up there?
Oh, I don't know. But somebody dumped water on the first turn, and Monty got into it and lost it, and I could see them lose it, so I backed off and made it through the corner.
Sometimes being a little further back helps then.
Well, I had no choice. The car was skipping. I didn't even know I was going to make it through it, but it did.
Not a bad way to finish it.
Thanks. I'd like to thank my sponsors, my pit crew. They did a heck of a job.
Nice job tonight. Feature victory on Napa night. Brent Currier, car number 30, the Country Home Center Buick. All the way from Johnson, Vermont. They get the win tonight. How's that, Norm? Pretty good? Yeah, Dad's happy. We'll let him keep it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a very brief intermission at this time while we count up our 50-50 money and stage the main event of the night.
Down trackside to wish the drivers luck along the way. Mr. Terry Ryan, sales manager, Napa Distribution Center over in Albany, New York. Ready to go on the point tonight. Driving car number 31, the Arlington Enterprises Buick. From Williamstown, Vermont, Lance Furno in car number 31. On the outside point, the J&A Enterprises Buick. Car number 57, Jim Burton from Williston. Row 2, on the inside, comes the Vienne's General Contracting Subway Buick from Waterbury. The 69, Flipper Irwin. Outside Irwin, also from Waterbury, the number 29 machine. The Vermont Rental Property Chevrolet, Brett Wheeler in the 29. Row 3, on the inside, comes the Richmond Office Equipment, sponsored car number 97. From Jericho, Vermont, here's Dave Gibbs. Outside Gibbs, a solid run in qualifying here tonight, the Riverview Garage, Pontiac 6000. From Morrisville, Vermont, car number 75 and Pete Vecto. Row 4, to go 7th tonight, the Lake Maury Inn, Chevrolet Malibu, car number 09. From Orford, New Hampshire, Mark Marsh. Outside Marsh in the 85 machine, the Ghostland Credit, Memorial Sandblast, car number 85, Mike Pelkey from Barre. Inside row 5 to go 9th tonight, in the running for the Couillard Heating Oil Triple Crown and a $400 bonus if he can win the feature this evening. The Tillers Automotive, Ehlers RV Sales, car number 55, the Kentucky Colonel, Tom Tiller. And outside Tiller comes the B&R Racing Ford Thunderbird car number 1. From Hyde Park, Vermont, here's Boss Hog Redmead. Sixth row back on the inside, the Carter Sprinkler Service, Maple Avenue Deli Mart, car number 83 from Barre, Vermont. Here's Brian Campbell. Outside Campbell in the Bean Chevrolet DJS Transport Machine, car number 23 from Plainfield for Mike Potter. Seventh row back comes the Dave Whitcomb Service Center, Turbo Blue Buick. Car number 25 from Essex Junction, Vermont, Dave Whitcomb. Outside of Whitcomb, post position number 14, the Bluins paint and wallpaper entry. Car number 5 from Williamstown, Pat Corbett. In the eighth row back, the Times Argus, Darling's Trucking, Oldsmobile Calais. From Groton, Vermont, the 68 Jim Silly. And alongside Silly, one of the top point runners in competition here tonight at Thunder Road, the Ernie's Garage, Tri-Town Sunoco Chevrolet, the 89 track champion Burger Blake in the 27. Next on the field comes the defending Flying Tiger International Series champion, the Arthur's Department Store Buick from Morrisville, car number 40 and Dwayne Lanphier. Defending mid-season champion from 1 week ago comes next on the field. The Suntan Sam's WOKO Pontiac from Bristol, Vermont, 00 Steve Miller. Back in competition on the Tiger Tour, our next driver in car number 47. From the Granite City of Barre, the Parentoni Paving, Ford Thunderbird, Mark Graves in car number 47. On the tail of the pack tonight, by virtue of the plan one option, driving car number 20, the Jason's Dry Cleaning, Chevrolet Malibu from Warren, Vermont, Tony Andrews. Next on the starting grid, the winner of the Last Chance B feature earlier on tonight in the Pete's Auto, G&M Team Racing, Buick from Montpelier, Mike Knapp in the 80. outside of Knapp, also by virtue of a top finish in the B tonight. The Norman Bouchard Excavating, Racing Pontiac, the 49 from Morrisville is Mark Lanfear. And riding shotgun after qualifying third in the B tonight, the Napa Randolph Auto Parts, Buick Skylark from Randolph, Vermont, Kip Stockwell in car number 16. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the starting lineup for tonight's Napa Auto Parts Trophy Dash. We ask now that you please rise for our national anthem. Sunday afternoon, September 1st, the tradition continues here at the nation's site of excitement, Thunder Road. The Vermont Chevy Dealers Milk Bowl returns to the Barre High Bay. Trophy Dash, gentlemen, start your engines. Field coming to life on the front straightaway. 24 cars strong, ready to roll for the checkered flag and the Napa Trophy Dash. Still to come tonight, B feature for the Allen Lumber Street Stocks, the main event for the Napa Legends and the Napa Team Demo. The Thunder Road All-Stars against the Airborne representatives tonight for the glory of Team Demo Championship 91. Dash, Street Stocks, Legends, and the Demo still to come tonight. Ace car is in on the back straightaway. We are set to go. Ladies and gentlemen, select your winner. Keep an eye on chief starter John Hulbert. Here they come in three. Furlow on the inside. Burton on the outside. Green is out of racing. Lance Furlow. Furlow with a nose out in front. The 31 is your leader. 57, Jim Burton trying to tuck it down. He holds on to second. 29, Brent Wheeler third. Side by side. 69, Rucker Ruin. 75, Pete Fecto on the outside. Pierre Fecto, the 75. Red Mead in the one, and Tom Tiller beginning to move on the high ground now. Fecto in the 75, going to work on the outside. Flipper holds him off in turn three. Red Mead trying to find a hole on the inside, can't do it. Here comes Tiller up the inside lane. Keep an eye on the 55 and the 1, the 2 veteran. Whoa, Red Mead almost off the racetrack, gathers it up. Close call for Mark Hogg in the number 1 machine. Lance Furlow shows the way at the front of the pack, 31, your leader. Jim Barton, 57 is second. Here comes the flipper down low for third place. Rupert Irwin moving inside the Brent Wheeler machine. The flipper on the inside, moving up. He's got the number three position. Wheeler dropping back to fourth. 75, Pete Fecto and Tiller up high. Brent Wheeler hung out to dry in the high. Daylight, he's trapped up high with Wheeler now. second. Irwin is third. Facto in the 75. 29. Wheeler and Tom Tiller. Tom Tiller boxed in on the outside line. Trying to find who. Trouble in turn two. The 09. Mark Marsh getting around. Marsh in the Chevrolet. Looking to refire. He'll go left out of the field now. 55. Tom Tiller running the low ground. He's got the fifth spot now. The Kentucky Colonel is up to the number five position. Single file racing in three and four, 57, Jimmy Martin. jumped from dead last on the field. He now is sixth. Kemp Stockwell has come out of nowhere. Dead last on the field, he starts, and now he is sixth place. Check to eighth place as they come down to the green. Here we go. Green is out. Tom Keller goes up. Barton on the inside. Till on the outside. White flag is coming out. Here we go. White flag is out. Tom Keller has it up. Barton coming back. It's Keller. Tom Keller with the lead. Tom Keller with the lead. He is the checker. Down the line. It's the Kentucky Colonel. It's the Kentucky Colonel by a nose. Tom Keller in the 55 lets it all hang out. Ladies and gentlemen, triple crown for Tom Keller tonight. Of the year for the Pepsi Flying Tigers as the grand old man gets it done tonight. Seen a man smile as hard for second place as Jimmy Barton is tonight. What a great race. The Hard Charger Award for Bonds. Casey Craig is going to give it. Boy, here's a surprise. It'll go to Tom Tiller in the 55. No question. What a smile. I can't wait. Well, I'll tell you what, a great run all the way through the top 10 tonight. Third place finisher, the VN's car number 69. How about it for the flipper, ladies and gentlemen? Great run tonight. Attaboy. The Napa Trophy for third place tonight. That was a tremendous race.
Yeah, it was. The car seemed to come in real good, handle real good through the feature, and it was a lot of fun. But I want to thank my sponsors, VN General Contracting out of Waterbury, Midas Muffler, Vince's Variety Store, Sisters 2, the Subway, Village Decorating, and Valley Rental. And most of all, I got to thank my pit crew. They've done a fantastic job this year. They've been working real hard, and they really hooked it up for me tonight.
Good job.
Thank you.
Rupert O in the flipper, third tonight in the 69. I'll tell you, I'll say it again. I've never seen a second place finisher smile so hard at Victory Lane. That was a hell of a show. Jimmy Barton in the 57, ladies and gentlemen. The Napa Trophy for second place. I'll tell you, my heart goes out for you. You guys drove it as hard as you could, never put a mark on each other. Great race.
I was hoping he was too old, but I guess not.
He's never too old. I'll tell you what, though, you've been around here a time or two yourself. The 57 was really hooked well.
Well, Steve Miller had a lot to do with that. He worked hard on it this week to help us. I want to thank him for it.
Tremendous show tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Jimmy Barton, 57, the J&A Buick for second. All right. Let's get him down here. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Tom Tiller, your winner tonight. The 55. Attaboy, Colonel. I think they like you.
Well, I hope so. And I'll tell you why I really wanted to win tonight. Well, par 55 has been good, but we've had a lot of bad luck with it. Changed the number. And this car is going to retire now. We're coming back to 77 next week.
Attaboy. All right. All right. Now, I know you guys are awfully busy racing and you don't tally it all up. You know you won your heat tonight. You know you won the semi. You know you won the feature. You know, well, you know what that is, don't you?
What's that? That's triple crown.
You know what that pays tonight?
No, I don't.
$400.
Well, that's good. We can use it.
All right. Colonel, I know it's been a tough year. It's been a tough year, but you hung in there, and a lot of folks up there are happy for it.
Yeah, we've had a lot of bad luck. Just bad luck. You know, we've had flat tires the last three races. Last week, we put another engine in. The engine blew. Things like that. So we knew it would come back.
You're back.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, tell him you love him tonight, the Kentucky Colonel, Tom Tiller in the 55. And by golly, they're going to retire that number a winner tonight. What a way to retire a number. The 55 is gone forever. And by golly, the 77 will be back next Thursday night, and I got to like that. Tom Tiller, Jimmy Burton, and Rupert Irwin, the race of the year for the Tigers. Tear it up that well. Bob Patton in the 17, the 84, Sean McFarland on the point. 53, Les Abbey, then Big Daddy in the 69. Skip Patton in the 10, 77, Frenchie LaFouncer. Lloyd Moritz in the 03, Doug Murphy in the 80. 58, Brendan Moody. The 32 of Rick Dennis. Terry Reel in the 11, Kirk Carpenter in car number 33. 95, Paul Schnabel. Ralph Carroll in the 31. Bruce DeSambo in car number 2. Don Lowell in the 78. The 6 of Bill Herring. The 42 of Paul Phillips. And Rick Fleury on the tail in the 56. We're set. Oh, the heck with the flag. These guys have been racing for half a lap. Go ahead. Why not? Sean McFarland on the point in the 84. Bob Patton, 17, and Big Daddy getting a little punch from behind. No problem. 53 and the 03. They're going to come to grips here in a minute. 53 Les Abbey. The 03 Ron Weston. Weston and the old Lloyd Moritz car tonight. Sean McFarland beginning to pull away with it now. Bob Patton in the 17. Big Daddy and Ron Weston. Here comes the Cadillac to the inside. The 17 goes way to the top of the track, and he'll lose two. Big Daddy Don LaHue goes to second. 03, Ronnie Weston is third. Patton fourth. Then the 53, Les Abbey. The 42 machine up on its door at the top of two. A snap roll and a half for Phillips. Shut up. Not funny. He's all right. He's out of the car and loved it. He said, that's a three-ticket ride at the Champlain Valley Fair right there. If you could box that, you could sell a million of them. Paul Phillips in the Kyle Petty look-alike sort of number 42. Here we go. Green is out. No contest. Sean McFarland away with the lead. Skip Patton goes to second. Big Daddy to third. The 11 of Terry Real now fourth. Keep an eye on the 11. He's come from way out back. White flag is out. Way to the finish line is if he didn't lift his foot off the throttle. Wrong decision. He'll finish third. Big Daddy is second. And the first ever win for car number 84, Sean McFarland, as he'll pick up the checkers in the B. Carrying the colors. Now the legends are next, and I'll tell you right now, there is more oil and water down here next to the wall than they've got in the Persian Gulf right now. All right, third place after the bank shot off the wall in the final lap. Skip Patton in car number 10. Skip, apparently the wall is not the quick way around on the last lap, huh?
Wasn't. I don't know what happened to the car. It was holding, sticking, and she just went.
Bad time for it to quit.
Yeah.
All right, we'll take third then, huh?
Yeah. I like to thank my sponsor, Dennis Murray's Trucking, and I like to thank the 38 racing team for a lot of work in the car this week.
Okay, good job. Third place to the number 10, Skip Patton tonight. Big Daddy in the 69 gets second. Nice going, Big. We've got the Napa trophy for you here. Pretty good job.
Thanks. I'd like to thank the Northfield sponsors, Duluth Electric, Delary's Plumbing, South Village Groceries, and the list goes on. True value.
Next time you're here, we're going to make you do this without looking at the car. Good job.
Thanks, Dave.
Big Daddy, Don LaHue, gets the second place Napa trophy tonight. And our winner, the Rays Mobile Homes 84, Sean McFarland. Come on over here, Sean. Well done. That's the way to win a race. Get out front early and don't let them catch you.
Thanks.
Good job. Anybody want to thank on this car?
Sure do. I want to thank my sponsors and my family and the pit crew.
This is harder than winning, isn't it?
Yeah.
I thought so. All right. Sean McFarland, the 84, gets the Napa trophy tonight for first place in the B feature for the street stocks. Sean, it gets easier. You have eight guys going freelance, or you can run the old college football flying wedge routine and try and protect somebody. It's up to you. I don't figure these guys are much for cooperation. There's Barkham in the... Oh, Andrews is after Barkham already! That a boy, Tony. He's got my respect. 09, Barkham. The 25, that's Doug Doba. He's the crew chief for Tim Norton. He's got no idea. So what did I do? Here's Curly. Look at Andrews. He's after Curly, and Curly's on his team, for God's sake. That's Curly in the 44. We've taken the gas tank out of that car, so he'll be sitting duck in a moment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on that side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on that side. All right, are we going to count these guys down? All right, we got to do this loud because they're hammerheads and can't hear. Tony, shut up down there. All right, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 3, 9, whatever, 2, 1, go! Here comes Kurt. five. He's got Blaine Apple. Oh, Curly just hammered the wall. No, no, Tom, the object is not to hit yourself. Oh, look at that. Mark Barrier just hit his own teammate. I think Phil Scott is the designated smasher. Look at Chad go. Oh, they T-boned Curly. Mike Knapp just hit the flipper, and he's on his team. Ow! Mike Knapp just hit Randy Campbell, and he's on his team. Somebody clue Knapp into what we're doing here. Oh, look out! Look out! Ow! Oh, my God! Who was that masked man? Oh, my heart. That hurts. Look at Knapp. He's having... Oh! Tony doesn't care. Look at Mike Knapp in the 80. Look out! Curly's got Tony! Back up, Tony! Back up, Tony! Ah! Oh, Barkham got Curly! Rupert gets Curly! Oh, they're teeing off on poor Randy in turn one. They're triple teaming him. Oop, there goes the flipper's bumper. Oh, they're hammering Curly now. They're hammering Curly. Oh, Barkham got him again! They just keep nailing Phil Scott. The flipper's still running somehow. No, he's not. Ooh, right in the door, you dirty guy. That's McFarland. Here comes Chet. Look at him. He's been hiding the whole time. He turned his light off and everything. Ooh, look out, Chet. Oh, Sweetser got Chester. Look at Mike Knapp. That thing. Look out, Chet DeBerry. Oh, man, they just nailed the flipper. A good one. I think the flipper's dead in turn. No, he's rolling. Curly's got the flipper. They're teeing off on Barkham at the start-finish line. They've got Curly. Ow! The flipper is killing Curly. The flipper is teeing off on Curly. Ow! Get him again, flipper! Woo, woo, woo! Mike Knapp almost hit Rupert. He said, wait a minute, that's Curly. I'll let him go. Oh, they're killing the 44. They're trying to flip him over. Look at Chet. He's killing poor Phil Scott. Scott hasn't been running for 20 minutes, and Chet keeps hammering him. Look at the flipper. He got Curly again. Look out. T-Bone's after the ambulance. Curly's going to the pits. He said to heck with this. Look out. Knapp is after Sweetser now. Look out. Curly's got a head of steam up. I have no idea what's going on. I think Barkham's dead. Look at DeVarney out there, all by himself, trying to hide. Look at him, just doing donuts. Doopy 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 doo. Chet, you wimp, get in there! Ooh, the flipper, I think, is history. Randy's running again. How'd he do that? The 85 is still running. Oh, that could have hurt. Here comes, listen to the 44. That's Tom Curley. Doesn't sound real good, does it? Oh, look out! That's your own guy, Tom. I don't know how the zero is still running. Mark Bonnier's got nothing left. Whoa! Randy missed him, but he had him lined up real good. Everyone back away from the fence, please, and find a seat so everybody can see. Everyone back from the fence. Our police officers, would you help us, please? Everybody in turn number one, find a seat, please, or we're going to stop this thing. That could have hurt. What is he doing? That's Blaine Applegate. He's trying to suffocate himself. Blaine, you're never going to make the news at 11. Look at him. He's coming out. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. Run, Blaine. Run for your life. Oh, we got one burning. Red flag! Red flag! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Look out, Jettison's out there and they're still running. Get out of there, David! Red flag! Stop, stop, stop! Knapp's still inching ahead trying to get a beat on somebody. The 69, that's Rupert. And Tom Curley and the 44 have had a bit of a meeting of the minds, and I think the flipper came out on the short end. Of course, Rupert's going to come out on the short end of most meetings of the minds. Phil Scott, look at that 14. Holy cow. Down toward turn four. Look at him. He's just hanging out saying, man, did I just get creamed. I don't know who's still running, but we're about to find out. Go! Hey, Jonah! Jonah, nice job! You lasted about 6 minutes. He's one of those sports car guys anyway. He's going to go back and grab a Perrier. My money's on DeVarney. He's still hiding out there, that little sneak. Now Mike Knapp is burning. Now the eight. Mikey, 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 get out, Mikey! Don't barbecue your biscuits. We ain't paying that much. Randy's trying to keep the 85 going. If he gets it lower than 10,000 RPM, it's going to cough and die, and I think it just did. Is anybody still running? I think DeVarney is still running, and he may be the only one. Can anybody move out there? Chuck can move. Anybody else? The Gerber baby, has he won it? Can anybody else move? We'll give him a count. Yes! Sweetser is moving! We've got... Oh, Tony Andrews, you sneak, you! Tony Andrews, you snake! Andrews, you dirty snake, you! You know, doesn't it figure that the street stock guys would be the only ones left? Oh, Randy's back! I'd like to be home by 8 o'clock tomorrow, fellas. Ooh! Somebody tell Tony that the motor's in the front. Randy's teeing somebody up. Look out, he's after Sweetser. Yeah, but he can't get going fast enough. I think DeVarney and Andrews are smoking. Tony's in trouble. He's smoking like a cheap cigar now. Look at Larry Sweetser. That thing hasn't got a mark on it. Get him, Randy! Whoops, missed. Andrews is done. Andrews is history. That's it. Three cars running. Larry Sweetser from Thunder Road. Then Randy Campbell and the Gerber. Oh, Andrews is running again. It won't last long. Don't worry. Tony, you better go out in a blaze of glory because you're going out anyway. Look out, Chester! Chester! Oh, Gerby, Gerby, Gerby. He's running. They're both running. No, I think Tony may have killed himself. Yeah, but Sweetser's going to finish the Gerber baby. Larry Sweetser is still running. Randy Campbell is still running. That's one per each team. Well, wait a minute. Randy may not be running. Come on, Randy. Yes, yes. Chester, are you done? Look out. Chet, are you finished? Is it all over, Chet? Are you alive, Chet? He's all right, but the car's not. Oh, wait a minute. The 68's running again. He hasn't been running for a week. That's wait a minute. That's Jonah Houston, and I just saw him leave. Somebody stole Houston's car. That's a stolen car. That's Curly. No, it isn't. Who's in that thing? I don't care. What's good? He's been a snake in the grass. He's just been lying there. Whoop, there goes Randy again. Is that Jonah Houston in that thing? That's Houston. Look at him. He's just driving around. He thinks it's a race, for God's sake. That's a good way to put yourself out, Jonah. Look at him go. He's been laying low down there. That car hasn't moved in 25 minutes, and all of a sudden, I'm the winner. Sweetser's got the wipers on. I don't know if it'll help. Uh-oh, that's the end of Randy right here. That's it. Sweetser has not put a mark on the nose of that car. He's done this before. Of course, he's a legend. Randy just will not die out there. Look at Houston. I hope they clobber him. He's been cheating the whole night. That's as quick as Randy can go. It just doesn't get any better than this. Look out, look out. Sweetser's got him. Randy does a U-turn and he takes Jonah. Jonah Houston from the Times Argus. He's one of those sneaky journalist types. The kind to hide microphones under your bed. Uh-oh. Oh, he's turning left, folks. He's planning a left turn at this very moment. Oh, Lord. I don't know why Randy is still running. I really don't. There goes the old Cyclops, Jonah Houston. I thought they weren't supposed to go on the infield. Hey, Chet, turn your lights off. You're going to drain your battery. He's having fun. Get him, Randy! He's got bad intentions, but he just can't catch anybody. He's like a slow dog. He just can't catch anybody. Uh-oh. Don't panic, Larry. You may be the... No, Houston's running. I think that's the last gasp of Randy Campbell. Houston's going to kill himself trying to kill Randy, and Randy's dead already. Get him, Larry. Wait a minute. These guys are both on the same team. I think we have a winner. I think we have a winner now. Hey, Jonah, how do you like it? In just a minute, I'll find my molars and let you know. Sounds good. He's still running. Put him into the wall, Jonah! He's in hot pursuit now, baby. Oh, Sweets are scared. He said, let me out of here. I can't finish him. Let me out of here. Uh-oh. They're both dead. They're both on the same team. I think, ladies and gentlemen, that the Thunder Road All-Stars have prevailed. All right. Now you watch. Tony Andrews will start it up and drive it away now. Okay, gentlemen, you can climb out. It's over. Larry Sweetser is the grand champion, and the Thunder Road All-Stars have prevailed. Just wonderful. Think we ought to do this again next year? All right. Next Thursday? No. Just wonderful. Says leave the parts to us, so we'll let them clean up the infield. Hey, Blaine, nice job. You all right? That was awful. They say smoking will kill you. Where's Sweetser? Whoop, I almost tripped over somebody. Come here, Larry. Still running. Well done. Not a mark on the front.
Gotta keep driving backwards.
You ever done this before?
Never.
You ought to do it again. You're pretty good at it. First place trophy. Good job.
Thank you.
Where's Jonah? Where's the J-Man? Where's Jonah Houston? He finished second, I guess. Here comes Houston. He's happy. Not bad for a little sports car guy. You stunk. That was awful.
I'm sorry. This car absolutely wouldn't start. I wasn't sandbagging. I promise.
Right. Go home. You're not invited back next year. I'll tell you that. There's the real stroker of the night, Tony Andrews. What a coinkydink. She just all of a sudden fired, huh, Tony? Yeah. Hey, Chet, don't forget your light. Don't forget your... I got to get out of here. I'm going to smother Kate. There's more fumes down here. Like a toxic waste dump. Oh man, this was fun. Who else was on the Thunder Road team? Scott, you shouldn't even get a trophy. You were out so quick, it was like, that thing didn't hold up very well. There's your bumper. It says on the back of this one, Curly Beater. I guess they didn't though. That was fun. The flipmobile was in pieces. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Next Thursday night, the Chitwoods come to town. They might wreck more cars than we did tonight, but I highly doubt it. On behalf of everybody here, the staff and management of Thunder Road, please do drive carefully on your way home. We'll see you back here next Thursday night. Great night here tonight on Napa Night at Thunder Road. Drive carefully. We'll see you next Thursday.